Your liver plays a central role in total body function. It carries out a lot of activities in silence. There are not a lot of pain sensors in the liver, and therefore fatty liver disease is mostly not really painful. This can be the reason why fatty liver disease remains undiagnosed for a long period of time. And you might realize that you have the disease when you are in severe stages of fatty liver disease. So how should we know if we are at high risk of fatty liver disease? And what should we do about it? Hello and welcome back to Dr. Saalaar channel. This is Dr. Fatima, and today we are going to talk about some new approved ways to prevent and treat fatty liver disease. So if you're interested, please stay tuned. The liver is a large organ located at right upper quadrant of your abdomen. But why is this organ so important? Firstly, let's go through some of the jobs of our liver in our body in order to know why it is such an important organ and why it is so crucial for us to keep it healthy. The liver, as the chemical factory of your body, receives blood from your gut via portal vein. This blood contains most of nutrients that are absorbed from your meal. Therefore, the liver plays an important role as the first place that nutrients are being filtered and further processed. For example, the liver has a key role in handling sugars, proteins, and fats. It also plays an important role in regulating blood sugar and blood cholesterol. Your liver also produces a lot of key proteins that are needed for your body to function well. Your body continuously renews most of its structures, resulting in a lot of breakdown products. Along with the kidneys, the liver helps the body to get rid of these waste products. In addition, your liver makes bile, which is a liquid that is stored in your gallbladder. During a meal, the gallbladder will contract, and this will cause the bile to drain into the gut. There, the bile salts will help to break down and absorb the fat molecules in your food. This journey of the bile allows your body to get rid of several toxic substances and excess cholesterol via the liver. Now, it is really important to know, why exactly do we get fatty liver disease? When your food intake exceeds the capacity of your fat tissue, the fat starts to build up elsewhere, such as in your liver. It is known that metabolic factors are the main reason why a lot of people develop fatty liver disease. So, what do exactly metabolic factors mean? It means obesity, high blood sugar and diabetes, high blood cholesterol and triglyceride, and high blood pressure. However, it is not always clear why some people develop fatty liver disease. Genetic background might play a role in some people, making them more likely to develop this disease. Now that we know the main causes of fatty liver disease, let's talk about what exactly happens in our body when we get fatty liver disease. In fatty liver disease, the fat accumulates in liver cells in the form of droplets, which are mostly large droplets. And therefore, as these droplets get larger and larger, they fill up all the space in the cell and push other parts of the cell to the cell border. When the fat tissue becomes overwhelmed and the fat cells are really swollen, inflammation happens. And this inflamed tissue can release harmful substances into your blood, which can ultimately damage your liver. In many cases, the presence of some fat in your liver does not seem to be harmful or affect your liver function, and this is called simple or isolated fatty liver. However, when the liver cells containing fat droplets become inflamed and damaged, this is called steatohepatitis. When your liver is damaged, it tries to fix itself by creating new and healthy tissue. But if you continue the damaging process by your unhealthy lifestyle, the ability of your liver for cleaning up this damage might be exhausted, and as a result, the scar tissue might develop and accumulate. This scar tissue is called fibrosis. Fibrosis can ultimately lead to cirrhosis, which means that large strands of scar tissue alter the liver's structure. In cirrhosis, the main functions of the liver can initially be preserved. However, as the disease progresses, the liver struggles more and more to function normally. Eventually, the liver's function can become really poor, that problems occur, which is called decompensated cirrhosis. And the final point where the liver's function becomes insufficient to support life is called liver failure. Okay, now let's talk about the signs and symptoms of fatty liver disease. Most adults do not notice any symptoms in the early stages of fatty liver disease and find out they have it when they are being tested for something else, such as annual checkup or during tests for other conditions, such as type 2 diabetes or gallstones. However, when you have fatty liver disease, your liver blood tests are usually abnormal, but not always. If these tests are abnormal, they are mostly slightly elevated, but you shouldn't consider that as mild disease. This means that your liver tests can be normal or only slightly elevated, but you still have advanced disease. The other symptoms that you might experience is fatigue, tiredness, general lethargy, and right-sided abdominal discomfort or an ache on the right side of your tummy just under the ribs. These symptoms are sometimes reported and might get worse over the time. However, most studies show that fatty liver disease independently contributes to fatigue and reduced physical capacity, which can be explained by the crucial role of the liver in energy metabolism. You can experience more severe symptoms when your liver is more severely scarred. These symptoms include unexplained weight loss, itchy skin, yellowing of your skin and the white part of your eyes, and swelling in your tummy or your legs. Okay, now that we know a little bit about the whole process of fatty liver disease, let's talk about the treatment options. The first thing that has been suggested by a lot of articles and research is weight loss. Weight reduction leads to improvement in your liver blood tests, the amount of liver fat, and the liver inflammation, as well as the amount of scar tissue or fibrosis. The impact of weight loss on the liver improvement depends on the degree of weight loss. A weight reduction more than 5% of your weight is usually necessary to reduce fat from your liver. If you want to improve your liver inflammation, you need to reduce your weight up to 7 to 10%. And if you want to improve fibrosis and scarring, you need to reduce your weight more than 10%. However, you should know that even lower reductions in your weight can be really helpful for your liver. Therefore, the guidelines recommend a reduction of 7 to 10% of your weight if you are overweight. Even lean patients can expect favorable results from weight loss. In this case, a 3% of weight loss is recommended. The next factor that is recommended for treatment of fatty liver disease is your diet. One of the most studied dietary patterns is the traditional Mediterranean diet. This diet is characterized by a high intake of olive oil, which is rich in a healthy type of fat, and polyphenols that act as antioxidants, vegetables, fruits and nuts, whole grains, fish and seafood. It is also characterized by a low intake of red meat and processed foods. Several studies have shown the harmful effects of meat on fatty liver disease, especially red meat and processed meat such as hamburger and sausages. The Mediterranean diet is also characterized by reduced sugars and refined carbohydrates. And one of the principles of Mediterranean diet is to reduce fast food and processed food and instead use more home-cooked foods. It has been supported by a lot of studies that Mediterranean diet has a protective role against cardiovascular disease, type 2 diabetes, and fatty liver disease. In two different studies, it was shown that 2 months of Mediterranean diet led to a significant decrease in liver fat independent of any weight loss. And for this reason, a number of clinical guidelines recommend using this diet for treatment of fatty liver disease. You can see more specific characteristics of Mediterranean diet in this picture, which is a part of an article published in one of the greatest liver journals. The third important factor is physical activity. In fatty liver disease, sedentary behaviors are really common. Sedentary behavior refers to any waking activity characterized by a low level of energy expenditure in a sitting or reclining posture. These activities include watching television, using a computer, or traveling by a bus or your car. A 1.15% increase in liver fat was associated with each additional hour of time spent sedentary per day. The good news is that both aerobic or resistant exercises can be effective for treatment of fatty liver disease. However, most of the time, the combination of these two types of exercises can provide the best health benefits. The guidelines recommend that over 150 minutes per week of moderate intensity physical activity over 3 to 5 sessions, including a combination of aerobic and resistant training. Okay, now that we talked about the lifestyle modifications for treatment of fatty liver disease, let's talk about some medications. The first medication that can help you with treatment of your fatty liver disease is vitamin E. Vitamin E has anti-cell death and antioxidant properties, and that's why it is recommended for treatment of fatty liver disease. It was shown by a study that the patients who were treated with 800 units of vitamin E per day showed significantly improved fatty liver disease. There are also some herbal treatments that have been suggested by several studies. Pharmacological studies have shown that berberine has definite effects on reducing hepatocyte lipid accumulation, inflammation, and fibrosis. It also can help with lowering blood glucose and improving insulin resistance. The second herbal treatment is purine. Studies have shown that purine can improve liver injury and treat dyslipidemia. It also can improve insulin resistance and oxidative stress. Purine is available in some plants such as the roots of the kudzu plant. However, since this plant is not found everywhere, purine is available in the form of pills. I'll put the link to one of these pills in the description, but make sure that you consult your doctor before taking it. At the end of this video, I want to provide you with a picture, which is the summary of the lifestyle modifications that you need to do. This picture is also from an article that has been published in a great journal. That was it for today. Thank you guys for watching, and please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And if you guys have a medical problem that you think I can help you with, please leave a comment below and I'll try to answer it as soon as possible. Bye!